to be a star. Show the world just how special you are. Turn your cameras on America, that's right.
Starring, written, produced, and directed by the United States of America.
Some sections are funny. I hear Butte, Montana is not really a barrel of laughs.
No, you don't know that somebody in Butte, Montana doesn't have a video camera and right now is making a very funny tape.
That's right.
It's amazing what happens when people get a hold of a video camera. That opening was sensational. It was hysterical.
It was, but Ange, I felt there was something missing.
Like what?
Like our names. You know, I didn't hear anyone say, welcome to the Homemade Comedy Special, and now here are your stars, the great and glamorous Angie Dickinson, and the witty and funny star of Family Ties, Michael J. Fox.
ego. Michael J. Fox of Family Ties. We are not the stars. Tonight, we're the hosts. America is the star of this show.
We advertised all over America for people to send us their homemade tapes, their commercial takeoffs, their TV movie spoofs.
Yeah, and music parodies, impressions.
Oh, and the attack of the 50-foot shrunken applehead woman.
I think that's your favorite.
Oh, it is.
Now, never underestimate America's imagination.
Right. Andy Warhol once said that anyone can be famous for 15 minutes.
Well, on the Homemade Comedy Special, anybody can be famous for at least 60 minutes.
No, ladies and gentlemen, she means 49 minutes.
49 minutes?
Yeah, minus the commercials.
Who said we were minus the commercials?
Right. This is where I go to the kitchen.
Well, tell them why.
Well, because that's where everybody goes during the commercials. And wait till you see some of the homemade comedy commercials we have tonight. Where are the tapes?
He is cute, isn't he?
Angie, where are the tapes? Mm-hmm. Where are the tapes?
Well, keep looking. Can't find them?
No, where are the tapes?
In the freezer. Keep them fresh, like you. Come on, Fox.
Hey, what's cooking?
Some of the best commercial takeoffs I've ever seen.
Oh! What does it say?
It says it's from Dana Victor, Los Angeles, California. See?
I see it also says, play until done.
Well, let's play until done.
Let's play.
Whether I'm at work or play, I like to count on a feminine protection that makes me feel safe and secure. That's why I use this. A Smith & Wesson Bolt Action 30-06. It's lightweight and comfortable, and I know I can count
on it. Hey, baby, you want to get lucky?
Smith & Wesson. For feminine protection you can count on.
I'm hungry.
Well, we already ate without you, as usual.
Yeah, well, where'd you go?
Benihana.
What's Benihana?
Benihana, I'll tell you. Benihana is a restaurant. It's a good place to fry. They'll understand a single word they say.
Could it sure be ten and dry? So to the west.
That's right.
Soy to the diet conscious bourgeoisie. Soy to you and me.
Come on,
stuck in a dead-end job? Looking for a more exciting, fulfilling career? Then Harvard Law School is the place for you. That's right. Harvard Law School can train you for the most rewarding career of your life. For a substantial admissions fee, Harvard will train you to become a sought-after lawyer with many rich and famous clients. From there, the presidency is just a hop, skip, and a jump away.
Mr. President, the press is waiting.
Thank you, Ted. I'll be right there. I owe it all to the Harvard Law School.
Everybody loves new rope on a stick. It's the great new fun product from Rocco that looks just like a rope on a stick, but it's so much more. Look, hold it over your head or make it go around your neck. Now look, it's a whip. Swing at your friends while they swing at you. Try to wrap it around your legs. You'll find literally hundreds of things to do with new rope on a stick. You and your friends will want to play for hours. Now look, you can hold it out the window. Throw it up in the air. So you can throw it the highest. Take it to the disco. New disco rope on a stick.
You're a busy working woman. You're on the go and you're glad. But in this hurry up and go world, it's easy to forget that you're also a mother and the proud owner of a playful, cuddly kitty cat. A hectic schedule doesn't leave much time for them, especially around mealtime. That's why Kennel Nation has created Cats and Kids, the new complete meal for both your pet and your child. New Cats and Kids has the nutrition they need and the flavors they love, all in one can. Like peanut butter and tuna, liver and jam, chicken and honey apple cinnamon. New Cats and Kids provides 100% of the minimum daily adult requirements of vitamins and iron. It's SPCA and USDA approved. Cats and Kids. When you don't have time to make two good meals, give them one great one.
Tired of setting a new table after every meal? Cleaning those dirty dishes? Well, end it all with amazing new Reversatex, fully reversible tableware. The morning cereal bowl becomes the evening soup dish. Simply flip over this morning's dish, and voila, tonight's plate. There are Reversatex cups, glasses, even knives, forks, and spoons. Your table's always right with Reversatex. Act now. Order a complete four-plate setting and receive absolutely free these two-in-one salt and pepper shakers and handy two-in-one cream and sugar dispenser. Reversatex, another fine product from CanCon Company.
With cyanide tabs.
Try one, honey. Feel better, honey?
Cyanide tabs, the pain killer.
Is your lizard fat? Out of shape? Well, maybe it's time you heard about lizard aerobics. Yes, lizard aerobics. In just 1 week, your lizard will be in top shape. Give us a call. Get ready to twist your neck. 1, 2, 3, and twist your neck. Yes, it's all here at Lizard Aerobics. Call us. 1-800-LIZARD.
I tell you, that's the first time I ever hated to see commercials in.
Oh, and there's more. We'll see them when we come back.
Not to mention, we're also going to see TV takeoffs, movie takeoffs, and your own homemade music videos. And, Angie, when do I get to see Attack of the 50-Foot Shrunken Applehead Woman?
Check the fridge.
I think they're almost ready.
They're ready. Oh, the tapes are hot.
Whoa, put them in the fridge.
Good thing I defrosted yesterday.
Recognize me? In Tokyo they do, but trying to cash a check anywhere else is the piss. That's why I carry the Orient Express card. Better than cash anywhere in the world. The Orient Express card. Don't leave home without it.
Miss Sheila Brooks for Alvin Stein Jeans.
You know, I'm only 15 years old, and thanks to my mom, I probably make more money than both your parents put together, but I earn it. Sitting under these hot lights, memorizing hours of dialogue, and wearing these incredibly tight Alvin Stein jeans. I love my Alvins. If they could talk, they'd probably say,
I've got candy, little girl.
Oh, Alvin.
Okay, everybody. Say hello to Mr. Cheesehead. Say hello, Mr. Cheesehead.
Hello, everybody.
What do you think of the show so far, Mr. Cheesehead?
I'm a woman of many moods and desires. I feel fabulous, frilly, delightful, and special. I desire labels, lunch, expensive cars, and important friends. I'm all these things and more. And all these things are pretentious. And that's why I wear the perfume that pretends to be all the things I pretend to be. And all those things are pretentious.
Pretentious by Nouveau Riche.
Are you the victim of an accident or work-related injury? Then you are entitled to fair and adequate compensation. I'm Larry H. Sewer. Has this ever happened to you?
And now a few words from your phone company.
If you have checked your directory and are unable to find the number you wish, please stay on the line and a directory assistance operator will answer. But what if you haven't checked your directory first? Do you realize what you are doing? Just because you don't want to take the trouble to look up a single phone number, you are helping to promote a system in which thousands of people are employed to do nothing all day but look up telephone numbers. Think of it, you who are too lazy to look up one number. Think of what it must be like for those poor operators to sit there hour after hour, day after day, year after year, their fingers getting permanently stained with ink, their eyesight getting worse and worse, their very brain cells rotting away from the grinding boredom of saying, "For what city, please?" over and over, just so you contemptible scum, can avoid looking up one lousy telephone number.
For what city, please?
There's nothing I like better on a hot summer day than an ice-cold spurt. A drink that's cool, refreshing, and has just a little bit extra carbonation. Because a little extra carbonation never hurt anybody. Just pop the easy top lid.
Whoa!
So try the drink that'll keep you speechless.
Bert. The drink with just a little added carbonation.
Yes, 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 folks, it's me. Crazy Bobby Boyd. It's yet another crazy deal. I've gone bonkers this time, folks. They should lock me up and throw away the key. Yes, I've gone and done it. I've bought an entire division of the United States Navy. Anchors away, my boy. I've got submarines. I've got destroyers. I've got airplanes. I've got F-14s coming out my kazoo. Take this F-14. Please, I've got hundreds of them. It roars. It soars. It deploys. It destroys. It bombs. It napalms. Strafe villages. Strafe neighbors. Strafe everybody. Heck, you can even attack small Caribbean nations with it. But seriously, folks, no credit necessary, no down payment. I'm practically giving them away. And what about submarines? I got them, I got them, I got them. Nuclear-powered, nuclear missiles, nuclear prices. I'll take cash, I'll take trade-ins, I'll take credit cards, I'll take checks, I'll take money orders, I'll take your mother. But not your mother-in-law. I'm crazy, but not that crazy. Yes, yes, folks, I've got mad. And if you act now, buy this submarine, and I'll give you this M1 tank absolutely free. Buy a sub, get a tank. Buy a sub, get a tank. I must be crazy. Loco Bobby Boyd. Se habla español.
All right. I have got one more commercial that you have got to see.
All right, who sent this one in?
Our sponsor.
I want to tell you how much I enjoy you on Family Ties.
Oh, great. Tell me.
I enjoy you on Family Ties.
Oh, thanks.
You're welcome.
You were saying, Auntie?
I was saying.
Yeah. Oh, well, about, you know, how much you like me on Family Ties.
Oh, yes, I do. You're so, I don't know,
funny.
You're so...
Funny, right?
Yes, funny. And you're so, what's
witty.
That? Yes, very witty. And so...
kind of mature.
Very mature.
Thanks. Mature. I gotta go to the bathroom.
No, wait. You better tell them why. Some people might get the wrong impression.
Well, no, Angie. They're going to get the right impression because the bathroom is where we do our homemade comedy impressions. Mm-hmm. Don't you all stand in front of the mirror at home and pretend to be somebody else? Don't you, Angie?
Oh, you're not going to believe this, Michael, but I don't have a mirror.
You're right. I don't believe that. Everybody has a mirror.
No, I don't. I hire 3 guys every morning to stand there and tell me how great I look.
You want a 4th?
I want an impression.
All right, anything you say, sweetheart.
Remember, Michael, we're the hosts, not the stars.
That's right. And Bob DeVerde from Chicago, Illinois, is really a lot of stars all rolled into one.
He must have spent a lot of time in front of his mirror.
Rocky Balboa, take 1.
Hi, I'm Rocky Balboa. How you do? I think maybe, I'd like a date, but I don't know. Huh?
Rocky Balboa, take 8.
Hi, I'm Rocky Balboa. Hey, and I think maybe I like a date. I mean, I like women as much
cut.
As...
Cut!
What do you mean, cut?
Rocky, just read what's on the cue cards. You know how to read, don't you?
Yeah, I know how to read. Read what?
32.
Hi, I'm Rocky Balboa. And hey, I still like women. You know, but I don't know if I...
Cut! Forget it. I cannot work with this man.
Hey, you know, I don't think you're very polite. Maybe I can't work with you. You know, I mean, like, who are you? I mean, I come down here and try and do everything, and all you do is put me down. You say I don't know how to read. I can't do this, read the line. Well, like, who are you? I don't see you up here.
Mr. T, take 1.
Take this, sucker. I ain't taking nothing. I'm telling you, I'm looking for Balboa. I know he's down here, chasing around, looking for broads. What kind of champ is this man? He ain't no champ. I'm gonna kill him. You tell him.
You're a disgrace to the sport. Why don't you just get the hell out of here?
Shut up, old man. I'm talking to you. I'm on Balboa. I train alone. I live alone. I eat alone. Guess that makes me a loner. You tell Belball I'm gonna get him. He ain't no champ no more. I'm gonna beat him. I'm gonna beat him. I'm gonna kill him. You tell him I'm gonna kill him. I'm gonna kill Belball. He ain't got a chance. He ain't got a chance. You tell him, old man. You tell him. I gotta go now. Do some charity work.
Tonto, take one.
Man, Tonto go in town. Get robbed, kicked, punched, shot at. New York, strange place. Seriously, folks, me fun guy, play practical joke on Kimasabe. You want to date with Tonto? Call me, me and book, red pages. We'll have lunch. Love you, babe.
Beaver, take one.
Gee, hi. Never been on a date before. But my dad thought it'd be a good idea for me to come down and try and get a date. Since I'm 38 and still a virgin. I don't know, though. I asked Wally. He thought it'd be a good idea, too. But when I asked Eddie Haskell, he said he didn't think anybody want to go out with an ugly squirt like me.
Michael, are you talking to me? I can't hear you. I'm in the shower. And we have more impressions.
Angie's in the shower. Well, at least she's not alone.
I'm sure all this works. I never was very good at plumbing.
Charles Nelson Reilly as Hamlet.
To be or not to be? That is the question.
Oh. Hello, I'm Walter Cronkite, and welcome to Meet the Press Box. On our show tonight, we're going to be interviewing President Reagan. Our panel consists of Elmer Fudd, a member of the NRA, the National Rifle Association, and Jimmy Stewart, a member of the Actors Guild. And myself, Walter Cronkite. Mr. Fudd will ask the first question. Mr. Fudd.
Thank you, Walter. President Reagan, can you tell us what you plan to do about rabbit seasons being too short?
Well, Mr. Fudd, I can say that I'm going to try and do everything I can for these fine hunters and make sure the rabbit seasons are as long as possible.
Thank you, President Reagan.
Is Winston Churchill.
Rule Britannia. We shall never give in.
Richard Burton is Adolf Hitler.
Deutschland, über alles. We shall conquer the world.
Richard Burton is Franklin Delano Roosevelt.
I shall not let you conquer the world.
Richard Burton is Benito Mussolini.
You cannot prevent us from conquering the world.
Yes, Richard Burton is World War II.
My dearest Franklin, are you faithful to me? Are you to me? Paris is mine. No, it is not. I shall return. I'm here already. God, I hate this war. Save it for the crowds. See you on D-Day.
Richard Burton as World War II. From the people who brought you Richard Harris as the Boxer Rebellion.
Oh, we're back. Welcome back to tonight's show. Wait, can you get a shot of Doc's jacket over here? You got a look. Do you believe this? Where I would not be wearing an outfit like that to a bar mitzvah. What is your sign, attention? PG
Doc. I love you. Okay, enough already. I'd like to introduce my first guest of the evening. He's a urologist. Yes! Can we talk here? A urologist from Burbank, California, Dr. Murray Schwartz. Ah! What is this? Did you know about this, Doc? What is going on here? I don't believe this. Oh, I don't understand.
Greetings, oh white woman from the land of cream cheese, orthodontia, and wholesale buying.
What did you do with my urologist? Do you know how long, can we talk? Do you know how long my mother has wanted me to meet a doctor?
Yes. 2 years, 3 months, 6 days, and 22 minutes.
Oh, you lie. I'm not a day over 35.
The great Carnac never lies.
Not even to your ex-wives?
Oh, 300-pound mud wrestler, grab your tongue in a full Nelson.
Never overstay.
Well, coming up next is our homemade comedy news.
Right, right. Right after this commercial.
My arthritis is killing me.
Here, ma'am, try this suffering.
Why, thank you. I feel so good I can lift this pan.
Come on, Jory. I meant we'll be right back after one of their commercials. Come on, Angie.
Mm-hmm.
Try it again.
Oh, all right. He's...
Adorable?
Yeah. And he's... Bright. Oh, yes. And he's...
Well-informed?
Oh, yes. Michael J. Fox is, yes, adorable, smart, and well-informed.
Thank you. Thank you. You're just saying those things. You are just saying those things.
No, you're just saying those things, but I would have said those things. He really is a very clever young man.
Well, I try and keep up on everything.
Mm-hmm. I can tell. You know, I bet he's the type who never misses the news.
Oh, you're right. Never, never. You know, except when I'm working, like right now. Right now, we're doing this show. We're not watching the news.
We're not?
No.
Look at this.
Well, our top story for tonight. Tragedy struck the Love Boat and the cast of every primetime show during the shooting of The Love Boat Goes to Korea. The Love Boat and all aboard were lost when the ship was sunk by a Russian submarine, which mistook it for an American aircraft carrier.
Newsroom projector finally repaired. Film at 11.
Well, it was good news for the Tracy sisters. Janice and Debbie, born Siamese twins, joined at the neck and elbows, have finally come up with the finances for the surgery that'll separate them once and for all. While doing a striptease act billed as the human totem pole, the girls earned enough money to pay for the extensive operation. Next year, the Tracy sisters hope to earn enough money so that they can have their hands surgically removed from their faces.
Mad Dog terrorizes Encino, foam at 11.
Good evening. On tonight's national news scene, nothing took place. Opal?
Sheldon, it looks like a wrap on the local scene, too. Bo?
Coming in sports, Opal. Dr. One?
Mama!
This has been the evening edition of No News is Good News News. Watch for more No News at 11.
On the national weather scene, the U.S. Weather Bureau says there definitely will be some. Temperatures will vary throughout the country with the possibility of rain everywhere. A high-pressure system is building up above the inversion layer level, which could bring more weather tomorrow. And that's the news in brief. I'm Elliot Weed. Have a pleasant rest of the day. Respiratory disease hits L.A., phlegm at 11.
I love it. Well, we've seen commercials, spoofs, impressions, news takeoffs, and now we're going to see some homemade TV and movie takeoffs.
Great, great. You mean the attack of the 50-foot trunk and applehead woman?
Yeah. She's waiting for you in the living room.
Great. Okay, but this time, Angie, I am going to find the television set. Yeah, because they've been hidden in freezers and medicine chests and showers and toasters.
And I always find them first, don't I?
Yeah, but not this time. Not this time. Where is it, Angie? Where have you hidden it?
Ah, youth.
This is ridiculous.
Michael, is this what you're looking for?
Oh, no. This is too obvious.
Come on, Michael. Join me.
Angie, have you ever thought in terms of a younger man?
Yes, I have. Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah. What do you think of Tom Selleck?
Let's turn on the TV. I don't think anything else is going to get turned on around here.
They're the best cops on the beat.
What do you think of this, Jim?
I don't know, Bill. Let's run it down to ballistics. Good idea.
Police squad. They're small, but they're tough. These guys always get their man.
After watching the Brady Bunch, Tammy becomes depressed. She wishes she had had a happier childhood. She laments her situation.
Poor, poor, pitiful me. My mother was an alcoholic. My father was an accountant. I wish I were a Brady.
Thus, Tammy flies to L.A. to see if she can start life anew with the Bradys.
I hope I can be Jan's roommate.
Tammy calls every Brady in the phone book, but to no avail.
Hello, is Mike or Carol in?
Tammy becomes desperate. She decides to drive around until she sees the Brady suburban tract.
I hope Alice is cooking pork chops and applesauce for dinner tonight.
Tammy finally meets a person who knew the Bradys. He tells her startling and terrifying news.
I'm sorry to be the one to have to tell you this, but the Brady Bunch was canceled in the 70s.
With this knowledge, Tammy could not bear another minute of her wretched, filthy, and really boring life.
If I cannot spend spring break in Hawaii with the Brady Bunch, then I will drink poison and die.
I'm Tuna Perkins, and today on Mild Kingdom, Tom and I are going to look at one of America's gamiest animals, the North American bum. The encroachment of man into bum's territory is in evidence everywhere. New shops and remodeling is threatening to eliminate the bum's territory. But before we capture a bum for shipment elsewhere, we will tranquilize one, tag him, and place this harmless, colorful radio transmitter around his neck. In this way, we can learn more about the habits of the North American bum. Tom has spotted a large male bum coming down one of the newly remodeled areas. Doesn't seem to notice us yet, so we'll stay concealed so Tom can get a good clean shot with his tranquilizing dart gun. He's got him. Tom signals that it's safe to approach, so both he and I rush in. While Tom attaches the harmless, colorful radio transmitter device to the bum's neck, I'll get his measurement.
He's a big one. Tom will tag the bum's ear. While I check to see if the transmitter is working. There. It's done. Just in time, too, because this one's coming, too.
Yes, I'll have a hamburger, fries, and a large Coke.
No, my Nerva. No Coke. Pepsi.
That's okay. That's fine. That's fine.
Okay, so you want a hamburger, fries, and a large Pepsi.
Right. That's right. Hamburger, order of fries.
Okay.
Large Pepsi.
Right.
$22.
Francisco Tower Studios in beautiful downtown Moscow. It's a Dunyetsho with me, Ed Ivanovich, and the Duck Severhead Orchestra. And starring Yanni Kartonovich. And now,
boy, I'll tell you, my arm's tired. I just flew in from Leningrad. Gee, it's really cold up in Leningrad, Ed.
How cold is it?
It was so cold, I had to go out and kickstart my sled dog. Well, I'll tell you what, I met my girlfriend up there finally, Ed. She's a... Well, actually, she's kind of ugly.
How ugly is she?
She's so ugly, her hope chest developed whooping cough.
Oh.
I'll tell you what, though, she's got beautiful even teeth. 1, 3, 5, 7, and 9 are missing. Well, I'll be right back, okay? So everybody stay out there. Have a good time. Don't leave your seats. You can't anyway. The guards are at the door, okay? Let's have a good time. Ed, come on over. Let him say we all do this dance together.
Okay.
I really get a kick out of it, don't you?
Oh, absolutely.
Where's the music at?
Got it right.
Attack of the 50-foot shrunken apple head woman.
I'm a 50-foot... shrunken applehead woman. I'ma eat you. I'ma get you. I'm a 50-foot shrunken applehead woman. Ooh, nothing's standing my way. No, nothing's standing my way. See those people? Out of my way. I'ma eat you.
50-foot shrunken applehead woman. Praise on the blood of the unsuspecting.
Look, you guys! It's the 50-foot applehead woman!
Oh, my God!
I'm a fly. I like that, like an airplane. I'm a fly of everyone how I can look in and see what I want to see. I'm my blue son, the girl that 50-foot shrunken applehead woman.
Well, we've shown you a lot of comedy tonight.
Which makes sense. I mean, the show is called the Homemade Comedy Special.
Yes, but what would a special be without music?
You're right. You are absolutely right on target.
Wait, stop that. We're here to play tapes, not darts.
All right. You're right. I'll watch.
Okay. Oh, no. I don't think so.
Why not?
Because you're sitting on the recorder.
It's so obvious. You ever run out of tricks?
Never.
Thank you.
Muffin Man, the Muffin Man. Oh, do you know the Muffin Man who lives in Drury Lane?
Oh, yes, we know the Muffin Man, the Muffin Man, the Muffin Man. Oh, yes, we know the Muffin Man who lives in Drury.
You see the Muffin Man, the Muffin Man, the Muffin Man.
Oh, yes, we've seen the Muffin Man who lives in Drury Lane.
I'm a little fairy twas, and I dance for you. Oh no, not again, not again.
Philip Roth sent this original music video from Portland, Oregon.
Lying in the sun, but it takes me forever to get a good tan. Eileen Finney from Los Angeles has a better way.
I have to get some color. It'll only take a minute. Now I'll be right back.
I'm tired of this.
I'll be right back. I'm sorry.
For crying out loud.
A scary movie and it scared me.
Well, it's a fast forward.
Oh, good idea.
From the makers of the Illinois Toilet Brush Massacre comes the most horrifying picture of all time. Prepare yourself for the night of the living Mr. Rogers.
Hello, boys and girls. Welcome to my neighborhood.
A film so shocking, you'll slosh out of the theater. Night of the Living Mr. Rogers.
Come on, everybody. Let's go to the land of make-believe.
Friday at a theater or drive-in near you.
The same people who brought you Confessions of a Praying Mantis and Get the Net, Jim, now bring you the story of Jake Merritt, a man who used his violent temper to hide his real feelings. A man who used insane jealousy to hide his true love. A man who used a small cotton bag to hide his extremely ugly face. He was the Raging Elephant Man.
Just when you thought it was safe to go back and do your shopping. Killer shopping carts.
This is where the terror begins.
Look at that money.
Action.
Suspense. No one escapes.
Not the customer, not the employee, not even the dog.
Whether it's Halloween or a black Christmas. Whether it's prom night and you're dressed to kill, or when a stranger calls and he knows you're alone, you'll have to wait until dark to see killer shopping carts.
Angie, I just thought I'd come over because I thought you might be nervous.
I am now. What would your mother say if she knew you were in my bedroom?
Probably tell me to ask you for an autograph.
Oh, no problem. You got any relatives?
Angie was right. You are funny.
I told you so.
Except I'm still not sure about Butte, Montana, you know? And to tell you the truth, can you honestly tell me that Metuchen, New Jersey is a real funny place?
Careful, Michael, or we'll get letters.
Or even tapes.
By the way, some of our homemade tapers are with us tonight, and we'd like them to stand up and take a bow.
You home tapers, I'd like to leave you with three words.
I know. He's gonna say, watch Family Ties.
That's good. I'll say that too. Watch Family Ties. But I was also going to say, use your tripods.
Good night, Michael.
Good night, Angie.
It's an all-new Bloopers with motion picture put-ons and a practical joke on Shirley Jones. Then the moment you prayed would never come is here. World War III has begun. It's the ultimate conflict. As the A-Team's George Peppard and Jan Michael Vincent lead the world's only survivors through Damnation Alley. Be there.
お送りしました。女性の職業選択肢、サリダ、変わりました。
Omnisent by Liza.
こんなデザインにふさわしいとこなんてあるんですか？それがあるんです。3月16日、新宿沼津、特急朝霧新登場。東海。在中国、本場中国では、ウーロン茶の子は1級から6級まで等級があるんだそうです。朝日高級ウーロン茶登場。